gonna be my new pad sound or the texture for the pad sound. Because in this video, I want to create a track with you guys together. And that's the first sound I want to create. So in this case, I'm using my voice. Even I can't sing, I try to. And the next thing we're gonna use is a sampler. And I drag this recorded voice sample. And let's see what we can do with it. Ooh. So I try to make it as long and droney as possible, and to go even further, I'm using a voice stack, and I try to create multiple instances of the sound, and the first sound is gonna be voice stack 1. I want to pitch this up 1 octave. Let's go 12. No, let's actually leave the first voice pure and only use the second one. Voice 3 is left panned, voice 4 is right panned. And raise the... Okay. So we have now 4 voices. And I think I'm gonna change even the start position of one of the voices. Now I try to find out the right pitch. A1, 12 cents, okay, maybe. And then I layer an polysynth below this the sampler, so we have 2 instruments playing together. Oh, this sounds okay, I think, for the first idea. Maybe pitch the sample 1 octave down. Raise the voices of the polysynth. So now we have our first voice sample, which I created with my microphone. I created different instances of the same sound, one pitched up and one voice to the left panned and one voice is panned to the right. And we pitched everything down. We made an root key detection, and then we added a polysynth to layer a kind of synth sound below the texture. And we now have a pad sound, basic one. And I'm gonna use a reverb to make it even longer and dronier. So I think for the start it's pretty nice. Let's maybe add some delay to it. And what I always like is to use an instance of a cool force to notch out all the different harmonics or resonant frequencies. Cut out a little bit of the low end. Type in D sharp 0 because I want to play the whole bit in D sharp minor. Okay. And what we're gonna do now is to create a MIDI clip or a note clip. Maybe use a multi-node device so we can create actually the perfect fifth over this the root key. Or maybe make even a minor chord. Chord change, and we use the diatonic transposer to transpose the minor chord to a major chord when it's needed. So D minor, D sharp minor, and this should sound fine. So I changed a bit the offset for the play start of the samples on one of the voices. So we have more kind of a stereo effect. And I want to continue with creating a grid. Grid, polygrid. So now let's add some randomization. I think I'm gonna use one sine wave, and I'm gonna use a transport device. I'm always searching for the right tab here. I think Bitwig needs to step in and use some kind of a search field. I always know exactly what I want, how the module is called, but I don't remember in which category it's in. It's a bit annoying at the moment, but I think we're gonna get a search field, hopefully. So this is the transport module here, and you get a phase signal from the DAW, and you can divide these the beats into different grids. So I'm using that. And I'm using one of the gates, maybe one of the pitches. And no, actually, I'm using probability. It's maybe better. So something like that. And yeah, let's go with that. In here. That from RDSR. On this. So that's it. What we're gonna need now is a pitch quantizer. So we are always in the key of D sharp. And D sharp is basically all the black keys. And we need, of course, that connected. As you can see, I use this probability device here. And when all sliders at zero, you have never played the sound. And when you raise one of the sliders, the probability raises that something is played. So sometimes we have a sound played because of the probability, and sometimes not. So now we need, I think, a scaler where we can use different polyrhythms. Maybe use a filter device. Let's use this one here and put it actually here. And to use the notes from this one. And we use the ADSR to open the filter. maybe use a random modulator to create different octaves. And use also the steps. And use a different random modulator to maybe open the filter randomly. We have to find the sweet spot for all the parameters and values to sound good, right? And what I really like too is to use simple sounds, simple patterns, and then combine multiple simple patterns and sounds, and then you get a much more complex result, and it's also more controllable instead of using very, very complex sounds. But this is also pretty complex right now here, but it's I think it's fitting for the track. Already 20 minutes into the video, and I have to hurry up so you guys are not bored. And let's create some more stuff. And one problem we have is with the grid that it's actually always playing, so we have to mute it. It's playing all the time, even when the transport is on stop. But we can change this, and we use this transport playing module here. And we're gonna use a logic module, so we use an AND module, and all we're gonna do is we track this in here, and all the stuff that goes into the different devices gonna go through this AND module. And what's gonna happen now is that all these gate informations or logic informations are only going through this device when the transport is playing. So you can hear we have no sound at the moment, even when the probability and the steps here, the note steps, are playing. So when we hit play and the transport, we're gonna hear the sequence again. When we hit stop again, can see it switches to stop, and the AND modulator is gonna prevent the logic going through this module. So pretty easy. okay, let's create some drums maybe. And kick drum at first, and I always like to use the E-kick synth. And we're gonna go with E sharp maybe. D sharp 1. D sharp 0. And remove the click because we want more of a dual sounding kick because it's ambient. And go with this for D sharp 3. So more like a heavyweight drum. Then we're gonna insert an EQ to remove the low end. Sharp 0. And gonna boost some top frequencies, D sharp 6. So it's all in key basically. 2 and add D sharp 7 or 8. Something like this. And maybe add a reverb, of course. And maybe in front one of my fake devices, fake distortion devices. Just a tiny bit, so we have a kind of texture. The low end is already removed. Pretty nice. So let's create a pattern. And maybe try to use a sidechain to sidechain, audio sidechain, and go with amplitude for a small duck effect. E-kick, post, pretty nice. So let's add one of these clap devices real fast. It's always a good idea. And we can also use this technique with the notes. So we have D sharp 6. And duplicate this, and maybe different voicing, D7-5. And maybe use this time shift device here, and drag the first clap sounds a bit in front of the second clap. Maybe not so good idea. Let's use some rim shots. Always search for rim shots here. Let's use a random one. Maybe this, drag it in. That's not so good. That's better. Together with the clap sounds. And maybe use in one of the clap sounds one of these blur devices to create more like a stereo effect. Let's go with that. And we can use the same pattern here. And use some hi-hats. Go with that. Okay, that sounds nice. Maybe let's use an e-tom. Let's look at that. We have also a tune parameter here, so we can put in our D sharp 5 to high, D sharp 4, D sharp 3. Okay. And use a pattern, simple pattern. EQ it a bit. Use a long reverb, but we put the mix on 0 and use the automation here. Fade it a bit in at the end. Thank you. maybe let's try and delay. May use very short delay times. Maybe this, and we also use the automation to bring in the mix from the delay. I can track it. Raise the feedback, so we can use the same technique for the claps, of course, and for the rim shot. And I don't want to make this tutorial too long, but I usually take more time to tweak all parameters and values and certain stuff. But for the case of this tutorial, I just want to quickly move forward. Let's go with this. Maybe you use different timings. And use some reverb, of course. Put this down. Use the mix button to modulate here at the end. Okay, maybe add some lead sound or something like that. I always love to use this Modnetic device because it's so nice delay. Thank you. And I like to use this retro collar device to get some crackle and wobble. Small modulations, like I said in my tutorial. And let's try to create a melody line. Start with D first. We have an chord change here, so we combine this and switch to a different voicing here. It sounds a bit detuned because of the long reverbs here in the pad sound. I try to use the Softtime plugin, which basically just pitches down everything. Okay, and let's add one last track for the bass sound. Well, let's go with the saw. Use two saws detuned and make it mono. Use a bit of glide. I try to cut out the mid frequency of the kick drum here, which is possibly D sharp 1 or D sharp 2, something like this. So the kick drum has room. Or even use an audio sidechain for the kick. But the slow release, because it's ambient, it's not EDM, right? Fighting a bit with the pulley grid here, but we can, when we arrange our track, we can then decide if we have this one track on and then we switch to the other pulley grid. So we have different sections. So this is basically main melody 1 and this is main melody 2. Expressions can be used to make the hi-hat here a bit longer sometimes when the velocity is higher. Brings also a bit of modulation or alteration to the sound. I think it's okay for the first draft of the track, and you can see I moved pretty quickly through the layers, but I also like that because I want to get an idea out of my head, right? I have to lay down track after track as fast as possible, and now I'm pretty happy with the result, and most of the times I just save it and forget it. And weeks later, I open it up and bounce the tracks out and try to arrange it and create on other layers, but I never quite change anything more than that. So it's not like that I open this up and try to make a dubstep tune out of it or something like that. I choose my drafts. When I reopen my drafts, I choose it after my mood. So when I'm in the mood to make something chilly, then I use a draft like that and continue. Yeah, I hope I didn't move too quickly through some of the alterations, but I tried to explain something along the way, and I hope you learned something out of this. And yeah, I want to finish this here, and maybe I continue on another day or do another draft, and let me know in the comments if what I have to change to make it more visible or more better to view on YouTube for you. So that's it basically for this video. Thanks for watching, and until tomorrow, see you and bye.